Hey, y'all. I'm not sure what time it is. I don't wear a watch, but I think we're getting close to the 2 o'clock mark, and hope everybody's having a good day. Kind of a crazy world we live in, but, self-isolation, it's not all bad. Got to hang out a lot more with dogs and kids and playtime and get caught up on some paperwork, so hopefully everybody's being productive and staying positive and all that. John Laverne, I'm out here at Magnolia Cemetery. We'll get started in just a minute or two. I'm trying to avoid the landscaping crew. Seems like they're chasing me with leaf blowers and garbage bags, and had some people self-isolating around here, which is a great place to be if you're going to do that, because there's 155 acres of room out here, so lots to explore. But yeah. A little bit of noise in the background, so hopefully y'all can hear me. And this is not going to be super long, but just kind of cover some highlights. All right, so we decided a couple days ago that while everybody's facing this crazy period in our lives, that we ought to try to make the best of it, because Charleston's certainly beautiful. There's lots to see and do here. And as a tour company, that's what we do. We showcase Charleston to people from all over the world, and we can't stop doing that. So thought, this is a great time. We've got a captive audience sitting at home in their, germ-free living rooms, and let's continue to show them Charleston as best we can. So we're going to pick, various remote locations out in the city that we can explore and talk to y'all about, and hopefully this will add a little bit of entertainment value for those of y'all watching from home. But I'm in a super special place right now. This is Magnolia Cemetery, and never know if I need to walk backwards or forwards or how this works, because I don't do this whole like selfie stick Facebook Live thing. So I apologize for the lack of technical knowledge here. But Magnolia Cemetery, where we are right now, it's one of my favorite places in the entire world. I have loved Magnolia since I was a kid, and it's got a fascinating history to it. Back in the 1790s, this was actually a rice plantation. We're on the banks of the Cooper River now, and by mid-1840s, kind of the theme at the time is large cities all over the world. Their church graveyards were full, and they needed bigger places to bury everybody in the city. So they started creating these Victorian burial grounds in London and Paris. They were the first, and soon after, Charleston obviously caught on, and this is where I'm standing now, is what is now Magnolia Cemetery. Used to be Magnolia Umbra Plantation, but 1849 they had the first burial here. 1850 Magnolia Cemetery became official and became its own entity, so to speak. Since then, there's been over 30,000 people buried in this graveyard. It's about 155 acres here on the banks of the Cooper River. And let's see, it's downtown. It's about a mile and a half, maybe a mile from the city market, maybe half a mile from the Citadel. About four blocks away is way upper King Street, but this place is certainly spectacular. And I've loved this place for a long time, and for many reasons. One, aesthetically, it's spectacular. The wildlife out here, the birds, the alligators, the butterflies, the azaleas, the camellias, everything is just breathtakingly beautiful. And then, thankfully, Bulldog Tours, we got the opportunity, the honor, to be the first tour company ever in Magnolia Cemetery to be allowed inside the cemetery as a commercial tour. And we do our Spirits of Magnolia Cemetery tour. It's available pretty much every night of the week. Not this time in our lives, but we'll be cranking up real soon. And we refer to this as the most hauntingly beautiful historical place in all of Charleston. And I do believe that short of standing on the Battery at sunrise or sunset, there's no place prettier than Magnolia Cemetery. This place really takes my breath away on a daily basis or whenever I'm out here. But again, we're doing these videos on a daily basis every day at 2 p.m. We're gonna try to do some ghost stories maybe on Friday and Saturday nights at 8 p.m. So Make sure y'all check that out. Also going to be on Instagram as well. Today I want to talk to you a little bit more about Bulldog for those of y'all that don't know what we're all about. Not only do we love, you know, showcasing our hometown, but we are committed to preserving this amazing place that we get to call home. From day one, which was about 19 and some years ago, the business model at Bulldog has always been looking out for the preservation of our historical landmarks. From the very first tour that we offered back then to the tours that we do now, all of them, a portion of the proceeds go back to these historical landmarks that we have access to. So not only do we have Magnolia Cemetery here, which we help preserve with our tour efforts, we also partners with the Old Exchange Building on the corner of East Bay and Broad Street. If you've never been there, it's truly an amazing place. For any of y'all who love American history or love old buildings or just fascinated with Charleston, that's a must place to visit. We also have a partnership with the Circular Congregational Church. They have the oldest burial ground in downtown Charleston. The oldest tomb dates back to the late 1600s, and we go there at night on our ghost and graveyard tour. We've also partnered with the owners of the Old City Jail. I know a lot of y'all have done that tour. It's been featured on Ghost Hunters, Ghost Adventures, Travel Channel, and all that. I've also had partnerships in the past with, you know, the Powder Magazine and other local places that are trying to make sure that Charleston's around for generations to come. And Yorktown over in Mount Pleasant, that's one of our newest tours, and we absolutely love being partners with them. But you know, these old places, they're expensive and very tricky to maintain, and that's Bulldog's mission, is to help make that happen. And today I am at Magnolia Cemetery, right outside of the historical district downtown. I would go further back that way towards the Ravenel Bridge, but you might be able to hear the guy with the weed eater back there. So he's my nemesis for the day, so I'm going to try to avoid him. But neat thing about Magnolia is it's open every day to the public between, I think, 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. You can just drive your car in, you park, you get in, walk around, and you will be blown away. This place is spectacular. As far as the people that are buried here, it is virtually a who's who in Charleston's history. It's a variety of, you know, governors and congresspeople and mayors and dignitaries. There's also bootleggers, there's socialites, there's artists, there's poets, there's a variety of everybody that has ever stepped foot in Charleston from 1849 until present day. Place where I'm going to hang out for a very, very long time is, I don't know, about a half mile that way. And I'm just not in the mood to walk over there, but maybe one day I'll show y'all. But yeah, spectacular place to visit if y'all are here. Again, in the daytime, you can come visit on your own and just walk around. If you're here at night, absolutely come take our Spirits of Magnolia tour. Let's see. I didn't know how this whole comments thing worked yesterday. I'm kind of new to this Facebook Live, but it was cool to see everybody's engagement and the request of places they would like to see. I know some people suggested Dock Street Theater and the Battery, Ansonboro, the William Aiken House was one subject somebody wanted to hear about, the Portia Simmons House. We're going to cover as many as we can. Hopefully, this video series won't be too long because we all want to get back to our normal lives. But I can promise you, between now and then, we're going to do everything that we can possibly do to keep y'all entertained. Let's see some of the comments here. Oh, my mom knows how to do the heart emoji thing. Hey, Mom, $10 says the next comment is her telling me that I'm handsome and smart and that I get that from her side of the family. Let's see. I don't know if this is proper protocol. I know I'm all over the place. Where's the, oh no, did they disappear? All right, so I'm gonna miss my mom's response because it disappeared, but let's see, all these buttons. Nope, the ejection seat. All right, anyway, we'll get to the comments in a little while. Hopefully somebody on our end. We've got some staff members that are still helping out to make this transition really easy and seamless, and so we can all get back to work as soon as this is over. So y'all know who you are out there. Please address any of the comments, I'd say call me and let me know if there's anything anybody wants me to talk about, but I'm kind of in the middle of something right now. Anyway, let's see, what else am I missing? So yeah, we're going to do a variety of these tours over the next, couple weeks or so, and try to keep you all entertained, keep you informed. Hopefully you'll learn a little bit about Charleston and get to see some cool stuff. Kind of bummed that you can't see. Let's see. Nope, that's not it. I don't know if that will jump sideways. Now this is going forward. Y'all, this is really embarrassing. Good thing this is free, because I'd be issuing a lot more refunds. But anyway. All right, so I apologize again. Not being able to see the comments. I'll do better next time. I'll get my 12-year-old son to teach me how to do this. One of my favorite all-time views. I'll turn around so y'all can see it. I don't know if I can zoom on this thing. Nope, it doesn't work. Sorry. Way back there, you can see the Ravenel Bridges. That gives you an idea of the proximity that we're in right now. Just right on the banks of the Cooper River, right over the Ravenel Bridge there. You have Patriots Point, you have Shim Creek, all kinds of cool things. And then here's some of my favorite memorials right here. If you'll take a look at the detail of these things, just amazing, the artwork. Charleston's very blessed. And I'm actually on the board of the American College of Building Arts, and one of the disciplines that you can learn at that four-year college is stone carving, and they are teaching young and, I guess, middle-aged artisans from all over our country how to create things like this and also preserve them for future generations. And, you know, Charleston's always taken a lot of pride in our preservation efforts, and American College of Building Arts is certainly a great fit. And us at Bulldog Tours certainly want to do our part to make sure that, Charleston's going to be here for a very long time. Oh, y'all, I'm really bummed I can't see all the comments. Yeah, there's one, Jeffrey Epstein. I did not get, nope, that's not it. All right, anyway, it's John Laverne signing off. Hope y'all make the best of a bad situation, and look forward to seeing y'all. I should be doing another video tomorrow at 2 p.m. and then maybe a cool ghost story at 8 p.m. tomorrow. But you can tune in on Facebook. You can get on our Instagram. I don't know what else we have. MySpace, YouTube, Pinterest, whatever. All the social stuff that I'm supposed to know, but I don't. Anyway, y'all come see us in Charleston as soon as this is over. Would love to help y'all explore Magnolia Cemetery and tell you all about this amazing place. There's a long list of phenomenal place to see in Charleston, but Magnolia Cemetery, certainly one of them. And with that, love y'all, miss you coming to see us, but this is going to be over soon, so stay positive, and y'all have a great day. Bye-bye now. Oops, wait, stand by. Y'all, this is really embarrassing. All right, now I can now see all 719 comments. Zan, so sad we couldn't come visit. That's all right, we'll be here when it's all over. Zan, we're in Magnolia Cemetery right now. It's downtown, right outside of the historical district. Jamie, yeah, please come visit soon. Hey, Joy, hey, Gordon. Martha, what's up, girl? College of Charleston alumni here checking us out. And you need to bring your parents back. Would love to see them. There's my wife, such a beautiful place, sorry. Thanks for sharing. You're welcome. Please take good care of our kids and hope that they can go back to school very soon. Hey, Phil Furr, Roger, what's up, man? Deborah Floyd, Tim, blah, blah. Let's see. Anyway, lots of awesome people out there, locals and people that come take tours with us on a regular basis from all over. And we certainly miss y'all and look forward to seeing you real soon. With that, thank you much and have a great day. I'm definitely going to try to hit this finish in button so y'all can get rid of me.